So what has happened since? Maybe not much, maybe a lot. Of course, the idea of home has changed in the world in the recent years because everybody was sent home. That is, everybody was told to go home. And for those that have a nice home, that was good. But for people that maybe had difficulties at home, or a small house, or not a garden, or little access to nature, or many children at home, and maybe also the jobs at home, things probably went complicated. Myself, my wife was at home, so she was writing all her all the COVID documents for the hospital from the house, while I went myself out of the house to interview lots of, to make a documentary actually, to interview lots of writers and philosophers about the deeper meaning of the, what we called it, the apocalypse, the great pause when the world stopped. And that is something that is important because my context was more in terms of global warming and why did we stop everything for a virus, but as the scientific kind of scientific advice regarding the virus, but why can we not stop or change things according to the science behind climate change? That is actually threatening the livelihoods and homes of people worldwide. So personally, my home is just like it has been, and the kids have been in Iceland, a bit in schools, a bit more at home. While you could say that that we might have taken the lightest version of the coronavirus here in Iceland. So there was a philosopher that I spoke to during the COVID, and he told me that the apocalypse, the word apocalypse does not mean the end of the world. It means to uncover things. It means to unveil something, to make something obvious. So what the coronavirus showed us was, how fragile we are, how connected we are, how vulnerable we are to maybe small changes in nature. It showed how governments can intervene, and it also showed incompetence of other governments. It showed us the need of international communication. I thought it was almost like a fairy tale in some way, like a some kind of a Midas Aesop fable, because suddenly everybody had a device in their hands to know everything about everything in the world, but we only posted selfies on the devices. So somewhere on the mountain, the gods saw us and said, okay, they should know everything about the world, the inequality, the problems, and they could use these devices to make the world better, but they're only saving their faces. So, and because they believe they are individuals. So let's change the rules. Let's make everybody an individual. Nobody can come close to another person and see how it feels like. Okay, they think they live in countries with borders. Okay, let's close the borders. Let's see how they like living in a world with only borders and countries. And they're only posting selfies. Okay, let's take their faces away. Let's make them cover themselves with a mask. Okay, so how do you like that? We don't like that. So hopefully we will learn from this fairy tale.